Hi, I'm Alistair Chapman, and I'm here at the Sony Digital Motion Picture Centre at Pinewood Studios in the UK to take a look at the lens mounting options, the variable ND filter, in-body stabilisation in the Sony BURANO camera. This is one of a series of videos, so do take the time to watch the others for more information on the camera. As shipped from the factory, the BURANO camera is fitted with a PL lens mount. Behind this PL mount, there's a locking Sony E-mount. And then behind this, there is a variable ND filter and an IBIS in-body stabilisation system. The camera's sensor is an 8.6K sensor that includes autofocus phase detection. The factory-fitted PL mount is compatible with both full-frame and Super 35mm PL lenses. It includes contact pins for lens metadata, and it supports Cook eye lens data. If you need to use other types of lenses, then the PL mount can be removed. To remove the PL mount, make sure the camera is turned off, then simply undo these 6 Allen head bolts, the mount then comes off, and behind it you'll find a locking Sony E-mount. The locking E-mount mechanism features a small safety catch here. When fitting an E-mount lens, you should first ensure that the locking ring is in the open position by turning it clockwise, and as you turn it, you should release the safety catch and keep turning the locking ring until the white dot on the ring lines up with the white dot on the camera body. Now attach your lens by placing it into the mount so that the white dot on the lens lines up with the white dots on the mount body. Don't twist the lens. Instead, hold the lens still and then rotate the locking ring counterclockwise. And as the locking ring turns, you should hear a small click as the safety catch engages. You don't need to tighten the locking ring excessively tight. Finger tight is enough. When replacing the PL mount, the camera must again first be turned off. The E-mount lever should be turned anti-clockwise to the closed position, and then the PL mount carefully positioned so that the connecting pins on the mount line up with those on the camera body. Then the mount should sit completely flat on the camera body, and the 6 Allen head bolts can be done up tightly. The BURANO camera includes IBIS, in-body image stabilization. BURANO's IBIS system can work with almost any lens, including PL mount lenses, allowing you to smooth out camera shake even when using classic cinema lenses. IBIS is not a replacement for an external stabilization such as a gimbal or Steadicam, but it's very effective at removing camera shake. The stabilization settings are in the full menu under Shooting and Stabilization. When using a PL mount lens or other non-E-mount lenses, as well as stabilization off, there are two different stabilization levels, low and high. If you're shooting with a Sony E-mount lens, then you can choose between off, standard, and active. PL mount high and E-mount active stabilization are only available when using the camera's 5.8K and Super 35mm scan modes. And when using PL high or E-mount active, there's a small additional image crop. When using a PL mount or other non-E-mount lens, as well as selecting your preferred PL stabilization level, you'll also need to manually enter the focal length of the lens that you're using to ensure you get the optimum level of stabilization. In this example here, on the left, you can see a handheld shot taken with a PL mount lens without stabilization, and then with the stabilization set to low, on the right. Now the camera is set to 5.8K Super 35 scan, and we can see the unstabilized shot on the left and the similar shot with stabilization set to high on the right. When shooting using the Super 35 5.8K modes and a suitable Sony E-mount lens, you can select active stabilization for an even greater degree of stability. In this example, we can see the unstabilized footage on the left and a similar shot with the active stabilization on the right. As well as stabilizing your footage in the camera can record active gyro metadata that allows you to use post-production tools that support this gyro data. If you wish to stabilize in post-production rather than in camera, then the camera stabilization must be set to off or active. In addition, you should be aware that it's not possible to use the gyro data to stabilize footage shot at more than 60 frames per second in post-production. BURANO has a built-in variable ND filter. The ND filter offers between 2 stops and 7 stops of ND, plus a clear position. When the ND mode switch is towards the front of the camera, the ND filter can be controlled via the plus and minus buttons on the side of the camera, via the home screen ND button, or via the quick menu in steps, going from clear, then to 0.6 to 2.1 ND in one-stop steps. When the switch is towards the rear of the camera, the ND filter adjustment is fully variable. You can use the ND variable dial, or you can assign it to the optional hand grip dial via the main menu and project assignable dial. When using the variable ND filter, there is a clear position where the ND filter is not engaged. Then turning the dial will bring the minimum amount of ND, which is 0.6 ND or 2 stops. And from this point, the ND then acts smoothly and seamlessly all the way to 2.1 ND. When the switch is in the rear position, the ND filter can also be controlled by the camera's auto exposure system. You can use the quick menu to go between no ND, manual ND control, or auto ND. When auto ND or any of the camera's other auto exposure settings are selected, you can add an exposure offset via the quick menu. Auto exposure can also be enabled, and if necessary, an offset added in the full menu under shooting and auto exposure. As you can see, BURANO has some amazing tools to help you get great shots. The combination of IBIS, the variable ND filter, and Sony's amazing autofocus make it a great camera for fast mobile filming. At the same time, the ability to stabilize footage shot with PL mount lenses will be beneficial to many film style productions. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please watch the other videos in this series to learn more about how to use the Sony BURANO camera.